Hello world! In this new video, I'm going to go a little bit deeper into the Loop Deck Plus. For those of you who doesn't know what the Loop Deck is, can I see it? Yes, this is the Loop Deck Plus. So basically, it's an editing keyboard, just normal USB. This is the handy part. This is the jog shuttle. And these are all controls. These are controls. These are preset buttons. This is preset. This is fixed buttons. These are fixed buttons. And this is all preset. In the app that comes with the keyboard, which you have to download separately, but of course it's included, you can set up most of the buttons and dials for your own needs. In this video I will explain you how to do it. The problem with this keyboard, it is actually more like a Adobe keyboard than it is a Final Cut Pro keyboard. So these all work in Photoshop and After Effects and everything, but not in Final Cut Pro. Luckily, there's an app, the command post, where you can all assign these buttons separately, and that works fine. And also in this video I will explain you how to do that. So it works good. It's a quality keyboard. You can feel by all the dials. It's good. For me, the most important thing of this keyboard is of course the jog shuttle. I've set it up that by rotating it is one frame forward or one frame backward. And with this one I have 10 frames forward or 10 frames backward. When you push it, it will have a cut, so I can really precise cutting by frame selecting by frame and cut it by pushing. This is the reset. This is the D2 button, which I use for zooming in and out. So it's an unlimited dial. That all works good, but it has its limitations. It's a good keyboard. I'm happy I have it. Is it a game changer for me? It makes it easier. It's not a game changer, that's for sure. There is a new one, and that seems to be better. But if I see the layouts, it's again more for Adobe products than it's for Apple products. It's also not working with motion, which is understandable, but especially I think with the dial it would be handy. That's not working. So maybe in the future product or lineup it will come. For now it doesn't. So I will use split screen where you can see what I'm doing, how I'm doing it, and how it reacts to Final Cut Pro. And I have another camera fixed above this, so you can see what I'm doing on the keyboard. Okay, one thing which is very important is I have made for myself a clean sheet. So in all the sheet I have all the buttons and dials which I have programmed so far included. And for example, the CDI, the main, is one frame and cut. D1 is 10 frames and reset. D2 is the timeline zoom. I have to say, if you go to, for example, the library, you zoom the library. If you go to the index, you zoom the index. So it's a little bit more than just, it depends on which factor you go. I have renamed all the dials. I have renamed all the buttons in order, and I would advise you to do the same thing. I think if you're working on day-to-day basis with it, it's a little bit more handy and you will get the experience to know which button it is, but I haven't. It's just that simple. Even now I'm using a lot of pull-down menus because I'm not so very good at shortcuts. Okay, well, without any further ado, let's get into it. I will set up my gear. I will have a split screen so you can see what I'm doing. And we're gonna try, and we're gonna use this sheet with it. I have made screenshots of all the buttons, so yeah, should be fine. Okay, we'll get onto it. I'll talk to you later. And all the buttons are grouped. Programming of the Loop Deck is very easy. As you can see, the control dial is lit up in the app. When you click any of those buttons, the whole group lights up. So you can program all the buttons in the menu. However, these are the standard settings and I think it would be wise to leave them as they are. This is the D1 and the D2 dial. I have used D1 for 10 frames forward or 10 frames backwards and D2 for zooming. This of course you can program to your own needs. These are the dials for color correction. This is a little bit more complicated because you see we have a shadow and we have a highlight, but we have no midtones. So I have used the exposure button for the midtones. Vibrance and saturation are the two buttons for the main dial, and temperature and tint stay as they are. The other ones are set for other issues, like clarity is setting for general volume. These are the standard Mac buttons. I would just leave them as they are. The L and C buttons is one group which you can program to your own needs. I have L1 to L3 basically for retiming and showing the timing editor, and C1 is for clip issues like selection starts, selection end, clear selection, delete and more. The four cursor buttons are for changing my playhead. The up and down is going to the first or going to the last frame. Left and right is going to the previous edit or to the next edit. With the custom mode button selected, you have another control over your color correction buttons, but this has in Final Cut Pro hardly any use. And last, the color black and white, hue, saturation, luminance and the 8 dials beside it, you can't use in Final Cut Pro. They just are not intended for. I think they only work at Adobe products. However, in Command Post, you can assign specific tasks to both the buttons and to the dials. But of course, this is to your own needs. Welcome to this very quick tutorial. I'm going to show you in practice how the loop deck works. One thing we have not discussed yet before, that are those four buttons. And those buttons are, in my case, set to next edit, previous edit, start of the project, and the end of the project. So if I go here, you can see my line is going to the first. If I go here, it goes to the end. I have no edits, so that stays the same. All right. So let's say I make an edit, so I go, I go here and I say I want to have exactly at 58 seconds, so 58, I make a cut, I go to 114 and I make another cut. So now you will see these two are the same. Here I go. Next edit, beginning, next edit, end, beginning. So this is a very clear small sample of how to work with the loop deck. This works very fine and I'm really happy with that. So now we go into a little bit more detail. Okay, one of the issues, in my opinion, I have with the Loop Deck Plus is that P1 to P8 you can program in the setup file of Loop Deck, but the 8 dials you can't. But luckily you can do that in Command Post. So if we open Command Post, we go to Preferences, we get our Loop Deck. These are already programmed in Loop Deck, so we will not touch them, so we don't get any cross links between Loop Deck and Command Post. So these are as they stay, we don't touch them. So for example, this is zero, but in the Loop Deck program, that is append or E in Final Cut Pro. However, these we cannot program in Loop Deck as they are exclusively for Adobe products, I guess. But we can do that in Command Post. So for example, the first one is down, is shift rotation right by 1 degree, and up is shift rotation left by 1 degree. Number two, scale down by 1 pixel, scale up is scale up by 1 pixel. You can do that whatever you want. You can do 10 degrees, you can go up and down, change, that's all free. So if you say select, you get the whole menu and you can just type whatever you want, but I'll just leave them as it is. Okay, so what does that mean in LoopDeck? Personally, I always use all my footage in landscape, never in portrait. But if you make, for example, on your iPhone of my drone app, you make a screenshot, it will always do that in landscape, of in portrait mode. So we need to change that. And of course, you can change that by just rotating your image by the amount you want. But if you really want to do pixel by pixel, it will be difficult. So you just select the clip and you can see it changes. So let's do it quickly because it is 90 degrees in this case. But you also want to scale. So that's where the second dial comes in. I can scale it in and scale it out. So the point is, if you are having this clip, I'll go a little bit forward. So let's say, for example, you want to see, you can see the horizon is a little bit out of line. So if you take the ripple training guidelines, we will zoom in here a little bit more. We should be able to bring this one up. Why is he not going up? We even should be able to do this also here. It stays the same. So let's not do that. So now you can see the line here is fairly close. So if you want to know now you can do by one pixel, you can straighten your horizon. So that's one of the nice things you can do with the LoopDeck, in addition to additional codes in Command Post. One button we have discussed is the FN button. So FN is the same like the slide bar button which you have with the MacBook Pro. So if you put it, you basically have a second row of commands. So one of the commands I use very often is, for example, C2, which in my case is
play. So we don't get any
play.
Cross-lip.
And another button I use is C1. So let's assume I have at the end of my display, I'll add, where am I? I add a piece of footage, so insert. I scale it up a little bit. So now I can play, stop. But if I push FN, I can play backwards. So I can play forward, stop, FN, play backwards, stop. Also, if I want to, let's say, a cut, so I cut here. And I cut here. I have with one, I can select FN C1 I delete. So that's very convenient. As you can see by this footage, and this is D-Log, so haven't done anything on it yet. We're gonna do something which would be very good with the loop deck, and that's color grading. Now I have to say that I am not an expert in color grading, but we will see how it goes. So first we push P7 and that will bring up our color monitor. So, and I need to have my list because I don't know all the commands by heart, I have to admit. Okay, so if we bring the dials up, we can see that tint and hue. So with the whites, we can play a little bit. As you can see here in the bottom, we can, sorry, we bring here the white line together. I think it's actually quite good. Then we have the blacks is the mix. Then we have the contrast, of course, is the contrast, as you can see. It is the main shadows, so we can put them a little bit down. I will get some place here. I can see my own screen. Then the highlights, of course, is the highlights, so we can bring them up too. Just leave them back at 100. And the blacks, bring them down a little bit. We bring the shadows down a little bit. So then we have the saturation, that is for the main one. And then we have the vibrance, which is the blacks from the master. We have the tint, which we just did. We have temperature, which we can control good. I think that actually looks quite good. And so, and then of course the highlights, shadows. I have renamed one other one. We have the exposure still, as you can see on the midtones. So we bring the midtones up, down a little bit, and the blacks up. And I think we have all in all a lot better color. So if we play, this is drone footage in D-Log from DJI. Of course we can add a LUT, but I'm not so fond of LUTs. I like to play a little bit. (Clears throat)
this footage is shot with my DJI Mavic Pro in Nigeria, in Benin City, just outside Benin City in Edo State, where I had a project. So I think that covers the basics. As I said, I'm not a master in color grading, but it works good. It does what I have to do. So even if I use D-Log, then actually it's quite handy. The problem I have is that the dials are very light, so even with a small touch they directly change. So I think, except from the control where you go by steps and the D1 where you go by 10 steps, the other ones are extremely light, so but it works. So I think we leave it as it is. It looks actually quite nice. The ground is of course very orange because it's laterite. So the colors look actually good. We can do the luma. We can go a little bit up. So we have a little bit more vibrant. Yeah, that looks better. Okay, so that is my color grading in with Loop Deck on Final Cut Pro. And that was the last sample. So only thing now to do is to edit everything and prepare it for publication. So of course, my last thing is that if you like this video, please give me a thumbs up. Even better is subscribing to my channel, and there might be some more. Okay, we talk later. Bye.